Boiling occurs when the temperature of a surface exceeds the saturation temperature at the liquid pressure. Therefore, evaporation occurs at the solid-liquid interface. So we use the following form of Newton's law of cooling, where the heat flux at the surface is equal to the convective heat transfer coefficient times the difference between the surface temperature and the saturation temperature. Or we call that difference T sub E. So there are different regimes of what we call pool boiling, where liquid is quiescent and the surface motion is due to free convection as well as mixing due to bubble formation. Nukayama created a boiling curve for saturated water at atmospheric pressure to demonstrate the different regimes of pool boiling. So this shows the heat flux with respect to this delta T sub E, and it's that difference in temperature that determines what regime we're in. What we're interested in is when this delta TE is between 5 and about 30. And this is what's known as nucleate boiling. And since many engineering applications are associated with this region, we'll discuss this one in this particular screencast. Now, generally, when we're talking about convection, we find our heat transfer coefficient H in terms of our Nusselt number. However, in nucleate pool boiling, Rosenau has developed a correlation that will solve for the heat flux, and then we can use that heat flux and Newton's law of cooling to find our heat transfer coefficient. So let's take a look at this equation. Our heat flux is calculated using properties of both the liquid and the vapor, and it includes two constants, C sub SF and N, that depend on the interactions between the surface and the fluid. Let's take a look at an example and show you how to find the heat transfer coefficient given our temperatures, the fluid, and the surface. So we're going to consider a tube that is polished copper. And again, we need to know that to find our two constants. The fluid is going to be water. The change in temperature is going to be 15 degrees C. So the first thing that we're going to do is look up these constants for polished copper with water at 100 degrees C. And we find that our first constant is equal to 0.0128, and our N is equal to 1. So now let's go ahead and look up the properties. And let's just describe what these properties are. We have the density of the liquid as well as its heat capacity, Prandtl number, and viscosity. We have the heat of vaporization. We have the surface tension. And finally, we have the density of the vapor. Now it's just a matter of putting all of these values into our heat flux equation and solving for the heat flux. So I actually divided the calculation up into three parts to ensure that I don't make an arithmetic mistake. So this is part one, this is part two, and this is part three. So if we take a look down here at part one, we find that the answer is 629.7. Since everything else is in joules, we need to put the heat of vaporization in joules, so I multiplied that value by 10 to the third. So let's calculate the other two parts of the equation. The second term is equal to 399.1. And finally, we'll take a look at this third term. And this final term is equal to 1.925. So when we multiply these all together, we get for our heat flux, 4.8 times 10 to the fifth watts per meter squared. And now we can use this value to find our heat transfer coefficient, such that our heat transfer coefficient is equal to this flux divided by our T sub E, or our difference in temperature, and that's going to equal 3.23 times 10 to the fourth watts per meter squared K. So before we finish this, let's do a couple of checks. So if we look back at this chart and kind of estimate where delta TE is 15 and you go up to here, you'll see that we are in the ballpark with our values. As it turns out, determining that the units match is a little bit more complicated. If you'd like to see how I did it, I can refer you to another screencast.